Hello everyone, it's Jen from Old Tinkerer Studio, and today I'm going to show you how to make a security camera image out of a photograph. I'll provide the link for this photo down below. Go ahead and open the image. And this is going to be the Jefferson Memorial. Make a copy of this image using Control J. And rename this layer base. Now we're gonna make this into a fisheye view, and we're gonna darken the edges as well. So go to Filter, Lens Correction, and click on the Custom tab. You want to make your distortion negative 30. Vignette amount is going to be negative 100. And your vignette midpoint will be 39. And click OK. Next, we're going to add a grainy effect to the image. So go to Filter Gallery, and under Texture, go to Grain. Make your intensity and your contrast both 50 and your grain type clumped, and then click OK. Make a new layer and name this one Lines. Click on your foreground color. You want your hue and saturation to both be 0, and change your brightness to 50. Then go ahead and fill the image with the foreground color using Alt-Delete. Now we're going to make these scan lines. Let's go to Filter Gallery, and under Sketch, you want to go to your halftone pattern, make your size 1, your contrast 40, and your pattern type should be lines, and click OK. Then go to Select and Color Range. From the drop-down menu, select Highlights. Make a new layer. We call this one Scan Lines. Make sure your background color is white and fill the image with this white using Control Delete. Then delete the selection using Control D. And then drag the line section to the trash. Make sure your scan lines layer is active. Then go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and make sure your radius is 1 and click OK. And change the blend mode of the scan lines layer to soft light. Click on the adjustment layer icon and choose solid color. You want to use a light green. I'm going to use EEF3E7. Go ahead and change the blend mode to color. And change its opacity down to 70%. Now go to View and make sure Rulers and Snap are both checked. Want to drag out a vertical guide to 35 pixels inside the left border. of your image. Then you want to make another vertical guide 765 pixels inside your image. Then drag out a horizontal guide to 386 pixels. If you're using a different image, these might be different, but you will get the basic idea. And then another one that's 35 pixels from the top of your image. Now go ahead and make a new layer and choose your type tool and open your characters box. If you don't see this, you can go under Window and Characters. And I'm going to use AlterBro. Sorry if I'm butchering that name. This is a pixel I got off DaFont, and again the link will be below. Going to make this 20 points and white. Then go ahead and click on your image and type out the date. Choose your move tool. And you want to move this text until it snaps in the lower left hand corner of the guides. Make a copy of this text using Control J. And choosing your move tool, you want to move this into the lower right hand corner where it snaps with the lines with your guides. Then double click on the text layer, the new text you just made, to highlight the text. And you want to type out a camera number. And go back to your move tool and move it until it snaps in place if you need to. Make a copy of this text using Control J. And you want to move it until it snaps into the upper right hand corner of the guides. And go ahead and double click on this layer to highlight the text and type out a time of day. Again, use your move tool if you need to snap it back in place. Go ahead and make a copy of this text using Control J, and you want to move it until it snaps into the left hand corner, the upper left hand corner. And we're going to need to leave a little bit of space for this because we're going to be putting a red dot indicating a record button. So make sure that you have that particular text in the upper left hand corner. Make sure you have that layer chosen, and then just move it to the right. Since we're going to be making this red button about 16 pixels, use your shift and your right arrow key and move it over twice should be okay. We can adjust it later if we need to. Go ahead and highlight this text by double clicking on the layer. And type out REC. Okay, then shift click on your bottom text layer to highlight all of your text layers. Then right click on the selected layers and choose rasterize type. Make the top layer active and go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, Make sure your radius is 1 and click OK. Then you need to click on each of the other three text layers one at a time and repeat the blur using Control F. Then shift click on the top text layer and drag the layers onto the new group icon, and then go ahead and rename this group text. Make a new layer and rename it record. Choose your elliptical marquee tool, which is under your rectangular marquee tool. And you want to, using Shift and Alt to make a perfect circle, go ahead and drag out a small circle or about 16 pixels. Click on your foreground color. You want to choose a bright red. I'm going to use FD0303. Then fill the selection with the color using Alt Delete. Then go ahead and delete the selection using Control D. You want to use your Move tool and move this to the left side of the REC and put it into position. And you can adjust your REC text layer if you need to move it over a little bit. I just use my right and left arrow keys, so make it a little bit easier. And make sure you have the record layer active. Then go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, make your radius 3. And click OK. And you can go ahead and hide your guides using Control H. Make your scan lines layer active and make a new layer above it. Name this new layer Box. Choose your rectangular marquee tool and drag out a box around the time text to the edge of the image. Make your foreground and background colors the default. You can do this by clicking on the little black and white icon. Then fill the selection with the foreground color using Alt-Delete. And change this opacity down to about 50%. And delete the selection by using Control-D. Go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, make your radius 1 and click OK. Make a copy of this box layer by using Control J. Then using your Move tool, move the box to the left to cover the record text and button. You can use Shift and your left arrow key to keep it aligned. And then using Control T, you can resize the box as needed. If you hold down your Shift, it will make it easier to resize it and keep it in proportion. And there you have your security camera image. I hope you found this useful. Have a good day.